Hello friends, welcome to the 7th lecture in the video series lecture on pointers in C and C++ by GetGun. If you haven't watched these previous lectures in this series, please watch them first. I have included the link to the whole playlist in the description section. In this lecture, we are going to study about passing arrays to functions in C and C++. Basically, we will be seeing how you can pass one-dimensional and two-dimensional arrays to functions in C and C++, and how you can pass them using different types of declarations. So let's see, while passing arrays to functions, we do not pass array as a whole. We pass the starting address of the array to the function. Okay. So what is trying to say is that, let's say you have a function B, okay, and you declare an array A of 5 integers. Okay, so what will happen is that an array of 5 integers will be allocated, and let's say starting address of this integer array is 200, and you want to pass this array to a function f. Okay, so what will happen, what you can think wrongly is that inside this function there will be a brand new array created, and the corresponding elements will be copied to this array. Okay, correspond, but it is not the case, because it will be very costly. Let's say if you have large number of elements inside this array, then copying each element, corresponding element to the arrays, and then creating this brand new array will be very costly. Instead, what we do is, we do not create a new array. What we do is pass the reference of this array to this function, that is pass the starting address of this array, that is 200, to this function. Let's see how it can be done. Let's say if you have an array of integers having 5 elements, and if you want to pass this array to a function fun, okay, so you can write it like this, fun an array. So what are the different declarations of a function fun to receive that array? The first type of declaration is fun int array and 5. What it means is that array is a pointer to an integer. It means only that. It means nothing like that, that a new array of 5 elements will be created, and it is an array of 5 integer elements. No, array is a pointer to an integer, and if you pass this array, what will happen is that, let's say starting address of this array is starting this, where memory, where this array is allocated of 5 elements, let's say the starting address of this array is 200, then what will happen is that inside array variable 200 will be stored, that is the array will point to the first element of the array passed. Okay, so it is just a pointer to an integer. So that since the number of elements inside the array passed is not the case here, because it is only a pointer variable to an integer, so you can skip this number as well. So you can write it like int array with the size of the array unspecified. In this case also, it will be a pointer to an integer variable, and it will point to the starting element of the array passed, that it will store the starting address of the array which is passed. In the same way, you can, since it is a pointer to an integer, you can also write it as int star array, that is array is an integer to a pointer, and it will behave in the same way only. Let's say how you can pass a two-dimensional array to a function. Let's say you have an array R of 3x4 array, that is, let's say we have a 3x4 array having 3 rows and 4 columns, and let's say the starting address of this the memory location where this array R is located is 200, okay, and we want to pass this array to a function fun. So what are the different declarations we can have? The first type of declaration we can do is fun int R 3 4. Okay, so what this declaration means is, array is the pointer to an array of 4 integers, that is only the number of columns is matters here, the number of rows in the array is immaterial. Okay, so array is a pointer to Ar variable ar is a pointer to an array of four integers. Okay, so what it represents is that you have this array, you have this array. A brand new array is created here. Only what happens is that you are passing the reference of this array to this function. So what it will do is, let's say this is the original array, the array that is passed. So what this variable array will store is that the starting address of the array, that is 200, that it will point to the first row. It will point to the first row. And if you increment, that is if you do arr plus 1, then it will not go here, because look at the definition. Array is a pointer to an integer of four, to an array of four integers. So if it is a pointer to an integer, if you have a pointer which is a point which is points to an integer, and if you increment it by 1, it will point to the next integer. Okay, and if, but here our array is a pointer to an array of four integers. So what it will do is, when you increment it, it will point to the next array of four integers, that is this row. So if you do our array will point to here. If you do array plus 2, our array will point here. That is, you will not go here by incrementing. You will, if you want to go to next row, you can increment this pointer variable. Okay, so for this arr, this is one element. Okay, this treats the array treats this as one element. Okay, so since the number of row in the array doesn't matter here, you can also declare function signature like this, a fun int, without specifying the row number of rows. You have to specify the number of columns. Array is a pointer which points to an array of four integers, and it will act in the same way as described before. And also you can declare it like this, inside parenthesis. So array is a pointer to an array of four integers. Array is a pointer which points to an array of four integers. So we just see how you can pass one dimensional and two dimensional arrays to a function in C and C++. I hope everything was clear to you. If you have, still you have any doubts, you can ask them in the comment section. I would love to answer them. And please leave your feedbacks in the comment section. That will be helpful for me to upgrade these videos. And please like these videos and share it with your friends. And if you want these notes in PDF format, you can go to the link given in the description section and download there. And please don't forget to subscribe my channel, because I'll be uploading these type of videos daily. So okay, thanks for watching my video.